someone calls you fucking fat, they may be bullying you, but you might be fucking fat. Someone calls you dumb, it's mean, but you might be fucking dumb.
And that terrible feeling when someone does tell you that you're fat, you can use that as fuel.
This last week, you started taking a toll on me. I usually don't think too much, get my shoes on, head the fuck out. I've been thinking a lot. That internal voice that's been talking to me, talking about, oh man, you're tired. Looking at my shoes about 30 minutes before I put the motherfuckers on. Pushing back the time of that I go out to go run. So I decided to tape record myself. That internal voice I put on tape. Sounds like a straight bitch when I listen to that motherfucker. So if you ever have a hard time out there, tape yourself. Listen to what kind of bitch you're being. Stay hard.
If you're in a fight, you have to attack. You have to keep attacking. The enemy has to know he is not going to give up. You must break the soul of whatever the fuck is in front of you. That's what I realized. I was never breaking the soul of anything in front of me. So that's why I came with the thing called taking souls in my book. I started to devise ways to break a soul of a human being, of an object, of whatever's in front of me. If you keep on attacking something, nothing wants to stand in front of anything that is relentless. Nothing.
When you're running, you run for hours.
Days.
What? Days.
Well, he wasn't always this guy. I mean, how many ultra marathons did you run in a row?
I ran 800s in 8 weekends in a row.
Just stop and think about that, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen. 800s means 8 100-mile races. A 100-mile race will put you out for fucking 6 months.
Right.
It's okay. You saw them. We will show more.
Until your mind is open to the possibilities that I can do this, you would never be able to do it. Once the mind starts to believe it can be achieved, it then, only then, does it start to break down tactically how we can do this. Until then, you're gonna always lose.
The most important conversation you will ever have in your fucking life is the one you have with yourself. You have to look in that mirror and know this. There's so much more in here, man. Because I can literally right now be a 300-pound guy spraying for cockroaches still to this day if I did not look in that mirror and say, there has to be more to this.
Every fucking day I wake up and I don't want to do some fucking shit. I'm like, okay, man, do you want to be a bitch today? Do you want to feel like a little bitch? Do you want to walk around all day knowing that you could, but you didn't? You have to learn how to get up and do shit when you ain't got no fucking 5K, no 10K, nothing. Nothing exists. Your life fucking sucks. You're in the fucking dungeon. But guess what, motherfucker? I'm still going to get it.
And down here, you see it's about 3 o'clock in the morning, and there's not a car or a person in sight. If you pan over here, it's the same thing. Not a car or a person in sight. People want to know where I find my strength at, where I get my strength. I get it from a lot of places, but right now, this morning, I'm getting it from, there's not a motherfucker that's up. There's not a car, there's not a person. Everybody's in their bed, sleep, dreading that it's a Monday. Hate it's a Monday. And I'm loving it. I'm loving that. Where everybody's getting weaker, I'm getting stronger. It's not about the running, the swimming, the push-ups, the sit-ups. It's about what those things do for your mentality. You don't get better on the daggone couch. You get better by coming out here and getting the fuck after it every daggone day. Stay hard.
Today I was running, and this guy passes me in the car. It's about 100 degrees out here, 70% humidity. And the guy comes back around and looks at me. He pulls his car by me and says, why the fuck are you out here? I said, because you're not. Sometimes your motivation needs to be because no one else wants to fucking do it. We need doctors. We need fucking lawyers. We need dentists, we need teachers. We also need fucking savages. This message I do, it's not for fucking everybody. So I'm gonna say that soft bullshit about, do you have sunscreen on? This message is dangerous. It's too hot. I'm not asking you to fucking be like me. Do you? Stay hard.
Get back to fucking work. It's time to get back to work. Stop hearing yourself talk. Get off the podcast. Don't be on social media too much. Cut out all the fucking noise. Get back to the fucking mental lab. Because that's where the knowledge came from.
I brought some cookies. Want to try a cookie? You want to try from...
Stop. Dude, it'll be fun.
You're fat as f***.
Yeah.
You want to be fat?
Yeah, dude. Being fat's fun.
Your mind is full of shit. That's not okay. It's not okay. It's not acceptable. You need to work harder.
I don't want to be doing work.
You roll your fat ass out of bed and all you want is some damn cinnamon buns and shit.
Yeah, I love that.
Man, you are a piece of shit. What kind of pussy you are, man? You get off your ass and you start moving.
I don't want to work that hard.
You're not a man. You're no fucking man, dude. Like,
I'm sorry, I can't.
You're a fat, sloppy motherfucker.
Oh, really?
You busy? Sure you are. That's a lie.
And who's one more to carry the boats?
It was a 24-hour race as a relay team. I was with four friends. And the format of the race is, you know, you run a mile, I run a mile, whatever team runs the most amount of miles
right. Wins
the race. He had no teammates.
Found out, and the only message I want to get across to people is once you change one thing, your mindset, you can attack everything.
18!
Move me, son! Get it!
19!
Move me, son! I wasn't born this motherfucker! I made him!
Get back to fucking work. It's time to get back to work.
Boss at work or by that bully at school before you get your feelings hurt, take that 1 second to pull back and study them, because most people who are in good places, they don't care about what you're doing. They don't try to destroy you. Most people who do that, they're in a very dark, dark place.
It is 3:00 in the morning, and if you see here, it says 74 minutes on there. The phone actually flips over at 100 minutes, double zeros. So I've been stretching out now for 174 minutes. And you're probably wondering why I'm stretching out so late. Had to do a 10-mile run. Had to go to the gym. I'm writing my book, which is taking me a long time. Had about 600 emails and different posts. I had to respond to, you know, different comments. And, you know, if I went to sleep right now, it would haunt me. It would bother me that I missed my stretch. So life's about sacrifice. Life's about having self-discipline. Life's about focus, all those things. And it's 24 hours in a day. Make it work to your advantage. And yes, I do get plenty of sleep, but life is all about sacrifice to achieve what you want.
Rookie here, first timer, congratulations. You started at 6 a.m. yesterday and reached the finish line here in 30 hours, 18 minutes, and 54 seconds. So for those of you who don't know, David's commanding officer contacted me last fall with a lot of high praise for him as an athlete and a human being, and wanted to know what would be necessary for him to compete in the race. And then David followed up with me, and I said, well, you need to have done a 100-mile race or over 100 miles in 24 hours. So about a week and a half go by, and I get an email from him, and he says, sir, I ran 101 miles in 18 hours. And then I said, what about the other 6 hours? And he said, oh, I thought I only had to run 100, so I did 101.
A lot of times you have to learn to perform without motivation. You have to learn to perform without purpose. And that's what people think. They think I need to have this motivation to work out, to study, to be better. So if they don't have it, they just don't fucking do it. And that's where you fail.
This is the toughest man on the planet. His name is David Goggins, and he's accomplished some of the most challenging feats in the world. One of his most impressive accomplishments is completing Navy SEAL Hell Week 3 times, which is a 5.5-day training program that tests a person's physical and mental endurance to the extreme. Participants are only allowed 4 hours of sleep in total, and they're pushed to their limits with non-stop physical activities such as running, swimming, and carrying heavy equipment. Goggins has completed multiple ultra marathons, including a 135-mile race through Death Valley. He's also broken the Guinness World Record for most pull-ups completed in 24 hours with a staggering 4,030 pull-ups.
I have this voice. It's the right or wrong voice. And a lot of times that voice guides us into comfort. And my voice guided me into comfort a lot. But I had this other voice I heard my whole life saying, hey, motherfucker, what are you doing? Nah, man, we got to go over here. We got to go over here to that rock pile over in the fucking corner where nobody's at. That's where victory's at. My name is David Goggins. I created Goggins. Goggins is the guy that can take anything and put it in front of you. You want to break my motherfucking leg? So be it. I want you to think about me knowing that I'm comfortable being very unfucking comfortable.
I became obsessed with being the baddest motherfucker that God ever created. Am I that? I don't care. I believe it. And I was trying to tell him, once you become obsessed with something, obsessed, it's okay to be unbalanced for a while. It's okay. Don't be all this stuff people say. You got to be balanced. To be the best in the world at what you do. It's not about being a Navy SEAL, people. The best at what you do, you have to be unbalanced to find every bit of fucking energy and strength that you have to pull it off. Then you get balanced once you become great. And then you help other people become better from you being the best in the world.
I found out, and the only message I want to get across to people is once you change one thing, your mindset, you can attack everything.
18! You know me, son! Get it! 19!
You know me, son!
I wasn't born this motherfucker! I made him!
Get back to fucking work. It's time to get back to work.
Who's gonna carry the boats?
It's okay to be weak and to be able to show that.
They are lies, all of them. Lies you use to rationalize taking the easy road.
Life's too short to exercise. I'm just gonna be honest. There are so many better things to do than exercise.
That's a lie.
Ability isn't to do exercises like Lumosity. It's not brain exercises that keep you sharp. It's exercise.
It's not been a man. Playing with a rock like I'm Jigga Man. Gotta look a nigga in the eyes when you kill a man. Am I loud? Every while. Scrap. Must be rap. Cow. I ain't giving doubt.
We'll tell you this, Joe. You will never, never in life meet a hater doing better than you.
That's a fact.
Ever.